Welcome to Unlock Layouts. In this video, we are going to discuss our LDO temporary floor plan and as well as power plant design. Let's start the video. In our previous video, we have done some temporary floor plan of the LDO. So now what I am going to do, I am just going to change the floor plan according to the design. See, top side you can able to see this block. See, just because of this block, I am not able to achieve a proper aspect ratio like square or rectangular. Apart from this, internally we have other blocks, so which is compactly fitting into the LDO design. But just because of the top level block, I am not able to complete the proper aspect ratio. So what I am going to do now, I am just going to change the floor plan of this top level design. Previously, I kept all the blocks in a straight line. So now just because of that, my floor plan is not making a proper aspect ratio. So what I have changed here, so instead of keeping in a straight line, I just removed two blocks from the straight line. I just kept it bottom of the three blocks. So as I shown here, I have just changed the floor plan of my design. That's all. Apart from that, routing and whatever we have followed here, everything is same here. But just I have literally changed the floor plan according to my design.
Then select this and then just move the device to here. See, when you take a look, right? So this is almost look like a square. Of course, there are some empty spaces. So here and there, there are some empty spaces are available. Okay, so that part we cannot avoid. So there are some empty spaces in between these two devices. So here and here there are some empty spaces. So we should not leave this empty space. Somehow we have to adjust these empty spaces. But for this block, right, so we cannot do anything. This, apart from this, we cannot do anything. So these transistors and resistors are not a critical devices. We can place it anywhere, because these resistors may come some in between these places, these resistors and other transistors may come. So our diff pair is here. I just kept it here. So this is not a permanent. So I just kept my diff pair here. But my effective LDO is like L shape. So leave about these devices. So these devices may come and sit anywhere. So my LDO temporary floor plan is like L shape. This is like empty space. Okay, so here I am not going to keep any devices until unless it's necessary. So this place is completely empty. So my LDO is taking L shape of the floor plan. So first of all, when you completed this floor plan, we have to get approval from the designer and as well as our layout manager.
Based on the top level design, your layout manager will give you the feedback whether this square shape is okay, or else if you want to change any other design changes with respect to floor plan. So all those other details, you will get it from your manager. Once everything is finalized, then we have to move to the internal connection between the block to block connection. So when your approval is okay, or else when your manager is okay with this kind of design, then you have to go to the next step, that is called internal connection between the block to block.
We have to create a power mesh, or else we have to create a power distribution line to the individual devices. So each and every individual devices should connect to the power line individually. That is the second important work we have to follow after completion of our floor plan. So this floor plan, right, so there are some blocks, like this is our error amplifier and other blocks are there. So these blocks can move from one place to another place. So this is not a fixed place. At the time of doing routing, we can just move these blocks from here and there. But as of now, this floor plan is fixed. Okay, then the next step is power mesh creation. So then we have to create a power line, VDD and VSS power line for the corresponding LDO block. So now what I'm going to do, I'm going to create option, and I have option called wiring. So in that wiring, I have option called bus. So you can call the same function by clicking Ctrl Shift X. So I'm just clicking this and go to F3. So in this option, what I'm going to do, so net name is not mandatory for me. I'm going to create 5 micrometers of metal width, and as well as I'm keeping as a metal spacing between two metals is 0.1. I need a 5 metal lines. Okay, just click hide. So this click the M2 metal and draw the metal path here.
So totally what I have designed here, I have generated 5 metal lines. So what I am going to do, I am just going to change all the metal parameters. Just go on Q, instead of M2, I am going to take this as a M3. Just apply, click the one more metal and go to the property. I need a M4. So just change the metal lines properties. From M1 to M5, I am just going to change the property of all the metals. Just go and then finally I need a M5 metal. Click M5 and apply. So here I have M1, M2, M3, M4, M5 metals. So this is my power line. So what I am going to do, I am going to select all the metals. Then just keep all the metals in the same row. So these all the metals are in the same one upon one. So this is like a, I have stacked from M1 to M5. Then go to via option. Always click auto via for this kind of connections. Then go here and click this, then see automatically the vias are placed here. So that's all. So once your power line is created, just select all the power lines and go to create option and make it as a group. So this is our VDD line and make it as a one more copy and keep it down. So this is our VSS line. So totally we have created two power lines, one is for VDD and one is for our VSS. So just keep this VDD and VSS here. So and then what we have to do, so generally all the metals should connect with M1. So go to M1, click this M1 option. So then come to this power line, this is our VDD line. So just align the VDD metal to here. Now I just align the VDD power line to this substrate ring. Okay, so all the top devices are connected to this VDD line. So first our VDD connection is over, then we have to give our VSS connection. So now I am not going to create any VSS connection here, just I have given a VDD connection alone. I am going to tell you how to distribute the VDD power signal to the power MOSFET. Input and output connections of this power MOSFET is very much important. So now what I am going to do, I am going to tell you how to do the power connections. So the best way to do the power connection for PMOS is like here we have taken VDD power line of like 5 micrometer metal with the VDD power line we have taken. So here internal connections are already made, it is completely clean. See, the next step is we have to distribute power to the VDD line. Okay, so go to path, I am selecting M4 metal. So just I am going to extend this M4 up to here and same one more M4 metal I am going to take it as a copy. So this metal I am connecting to the VDD, that's all. This is connected to VDD and this VDD power line is here, exactly here. Okay, so then stretch this metal if you want, then leave it. So this is our input connection of VDD. Our VDD line is connecting from the main power line. Okay, so the next step is like come to the layout, just enable this. See here, the first net is our VDD and second net is our VSS connection. So what we have to do, right, just select this M2, stretch this M2 metal up to here. Okay, so second thing, same again, come to the second option, second metal of source, just extend this. So meanwhile what you have to do, you have to do the same thing, you have to do it for the all other nets. So wherever you are seeing the VDD, so we have to do the same step or same procedure we have to follow for the all other VDD nets. See, as I told, in all the individual nets are connected individually to this M4. So this is individually connected to this M4. Then again go to via option, just place auto via, click here and place auto via, that's all. So place the via to every individual nets. I think we have completed everything. Individually we have given all the VDD signals to the power MOSFET. Then what we have to do, from the input just keep 1.5 micrometers of scaling, just keep 1.5 micrometer and then align this output metal. So this is our input line and this is our output line. So what I am going to do as for output, same method whatever we have done previously, the same method I am going to follow here. Same, this is our output net, right? Just extend this output net to this M4. So this is our first output and then the second output net is here.
So we have multiple outputs and multiple inputs because we have distributed all the power connection in separately. So this is our input and this is our output. Okay, so same way you have to follow the same procedure for all other rest of the nets. So that's all. So we have taken all the connections separately and all the VDD connection, VSS connection separately. Just go to auto via option, place a via to the output net. See, manually placing via will take lot of time, so I'm just taking auto via option. Okay, see, everywhere the output is connected to the separate net. So this is our source and drain connection is over. Then the final, I hope I have given some valuable information to you in this video. Thank you for watching my video. If you like this video, please click like button and share this video to your friends. For more details about this video, please contact us to my email ID and follow us on my Facebook page and Twitter page, and kindly subscribe our channel and don't forget to click the bell button.